Okay, good morning to all of you. I welcome to all in our lecture series on statistical mechanics, that is your core paper 14, belongs to 6th semester BSc syllabus. In our last class, we have been discussed Fermi-Dirac statistics, and we derived Fermi-Dirac distribution law. The whole derivation we have been discussed in detail, okay, with two examples. And here we found the thermodynamic probability for a particular macrostate is this one, Gi factorial summation multiplication summation of Gi factorial by Ni factorial into Gi minus Ni factorial. And then we derived by considering equilibrium condition, we found the Fermi-Dirac distribution law. This is equation number 9, represents Fermi-Dirac distribution law. In detail we have been discussed, and this notes PDF I have been given the in my description. And the PDF of this note, Fermi-Dirac statistics, I have been given the link in that description. You can download also. Okay. And in our today class, we are going to be discuss density of states. Here, density of states means what are the number of eigenstates possible in between a range of momentum p plus dp, or you can say epsilon to epsilon plus d epsilon. How many number of eigenstates possible for the fermions? Okay, here we have been considered a point particle, and we extracted the density of states, or you can say number of quantum states or number of phase cells, unit cells, in the range between epsilon and epsilon plus d epsilon. Okay. Similar type of derivation also we have been done previously after the Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution. This is your Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution law derivation. After that, you can see, you can check your note, you can found that GPDP represents number of phase space cells. Here phase space cells, here it is another language that is called as the quantum state. This is a similar what I can say, physical behavior. Okay, here the number of phase space cells means it represents the quantum states itself. And here also you can check, we found that GPDP is nothing but this is a total volume occupied by the particular molecule in the phase space divided by volume of each cell. Then we can found the number of phase space cells, unit cells. Okay, so total volume by volume of each cell will be give the number of phase space unit cell or quantum states present in that phase space. Okay, and also we done a example here that find the number of microstates in the energy range epsilon and epsilon plus d epsilon for a single particle, and we found GED equal to this much. Exactly same procedure we are going to be follow for derivation of the density of states. And here density of states derivation has been done by considering a single particle, that is your electron. By considering a point particle electron, what will be the value? But the procedure will be same as this one, whatever we have been done earlier. You can check your note just after Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution law. Okay, at that time we have been derived the number of phase cells, or here also in this problem we have been derived number of microstates. Microstates means the so-called quantum states we have been derived. The similar method, or say, I can say same method I am going to use over here. So carefully you have to watch and pause the video, write down the note. So in this section, the number of eigenstates in the energy range epsilon and epsilon plus d epsilon has been evaluated, where d epsilon wh, where d epsilon is small. We know that the volume of unit cell in the phase space is nothing but h to the power f, where f is the degree of freedom of a particle. Of a particle means here we consider the electrons, electron only. Okay, as this is belongs to Fermi-Dirac statistics, so here we consider the electron. A point particle means you just consider the electron. Okay, here we have to consider the point particle at the end. If we are going to consider electron, then what will the change, that you can easily understand. You just follow. A point particle in phase space has 3 degree of freedom and phase space dimension is 6. Let us denote the 3 coordinates by x, y, z, and corresponding momenta is p, x, p, y, p, z. That is your coordinate space means having the dimension is 3. In the momentum space, dimension is 3. So phase space dimension is 3 plus 3 equal to 6. Okay. So the number of eigenstates is given by in between p and p plus dp is gp dp will be equal to this factor integration of dx dy dz is represents, this represents the volume of the coordinate space, this represents the volume of the momentum space, right? So entire this integration of this one, entire dx dy dz integration, triple integration dpx dpy dpz, this is represents the volume of whole phase space. The volume of whole phase space divided by volume of each cell will be give you the number of cells or the quantum states. This expression or this method we have been used previously. I shown you that this one gp dp equal to, so here at a time 6 integration, this one by hq I have been written, and here separately I have been written. So there is no physical changes, just representation is changed here, so don't to be confused. So gp dp will be equal to v by hq. So v is here this one, volume of the coordinate space. This is v is the volume of the vessel in the coordinate space, where v equal to triple integration of dx dy dz, and rest of the things is triple integration of dpx dpy dpz. Let this is your equation number 1. Here dpx dpy dpz is the volume of the momentum space of the radius p maximum, that is your 4 by 3 pi r cube, means p maximum square. So here this volume represents whole momentum space. Whole momentum space, if you are going to consider a sphere, then its maximum radius, suppose p max, then this volume will be 4 by 3 pi p maximum square. But we want to find out the volume in between p and dp plus dp. I don't want to find out the volume of the whole entire momentum space. I want to find out the volume in between p and p plus dp. Why? Because p and p plus dp, if I am going to find out the range of the momentum, then it can be easily transformed to the energy, because E equal to P square by 2m. So only for that, we intend to find out the volume in between a range of the momentum, that is your P and P plus dp. We don't want to find out the total entire volume in the momentum space. So in the momentum space, what will the volume in between p and p plus dp, that we are going to calculate. So integration of dpx dpy dpz equal to, that means the volume in between p plus dp minus 4 by 3 p q. The figure is here. I not drawn this figure once again. So the volume in between this range. This is the radius. This is the radius is your P plus dP, and this is radius of P. So P plus dP minus P. The region is this one. So volume of this sphere minus volume of this sphere. I can found the volume of this region or sphere. So 4 by 3 pi P plus dP cube minus 4 by 3 pi P cube. And that implies dpx dpy dpz equal 4 pi p square dp by neglecting higher order term of dp. So how higher order term has been neglected here in detail we have been derived. So once again I have not written directly, I have been written 4 pi p square dp over here, and here I written by neglecting higher order terms of dp. So that here you can see we have been neglected dp square and dp cube. Because dp is small means it's square, and cube and higher order is going to be reduce its value. So we have been neglected. So say here in 2-3 steps I have been omitted because previously we have been discussed these steps. So directly I have been written over here that 4 pi p square dp. In exam you can direct write, no problem, by neglecting higher order terms of dp. So therefore gp dp will be equal to gp dp will be equal to 4 v by h cube, and here this integration we found this one. Okay, so v by h cube into 4 pi p square dp. Let this is your equation number 3, and this is your equation number 2. This is your equation number 3, right? Now what we have to do, that we have to transform the momentum space, momentum terms to energy terms. How it will be? We know that epsilon equal to p square by 2m, right? Or p equal to 2me root over dp equal to 2m root over of e, derivative will be 1 by 2 root over of epsilon into d epsilon. Hence p square dp in equation number 3, one term is there, p square dp. So this p square dp is going to be written in the term of energy. So p square dp can be written as here p square value is 2m epsilon and dp value is this one. So we found m root over 2m epsilon into d epsilon. Now the number of eigenstates in the energy range epsilon and d and epsilon plus d epsilon is given by, that is your g d will be equal to 4 by h q into 4 pi p square dp. Instead of p square dp we have to substitute what this value, just simply substitute this one, that is equal to 4 pi b by h cube into 4 pi, this one, m root over of 2m epsilon into d epsilon. Okay, now g e d e will be equal to 4 pi v m by h cube 2m epsilon root over into d epsilon. Let this is your equation number 4. This is your equation number 4. See here. Here also same thing we have been done, okay? Same thing, G, D, E. In the last previous one that I am going to say, that is your after Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution, whatever the question we have been done. Same expression we found, see. This is same. 4 pi V, this is root over of 2, same thing. You just, here we written M to the power 3 by 2, here. The same thing, same here, this one and this one is the same expression. Okay, but considering the spin degeneracy factor, so this equation number 4 represents the number of eigenstates in the energy range epsilon and d epsilon to whom, for the one single particle, okay, for the single particle which is in a phase space having number of eigenstates, possible number of eigenstates are this one, right? But if we are going to consider the spin degeneracy factor caused by the particles of spin S, because as we are considering the fermions in this topic, so fermions have spin degeneracy factor, because on the base of the spin they can degenerate the energy level, same energy level, but energy up and energy down direction will be create another two distinguished energy states. So degeneracy factor will be possible for the fermions. So spin degeneracy factor caused by the particles of the spin S, that is GS, will be equal to 2s plus 1. The number of states between energy but considering the spin degeneracy factor caused by the particle of spin this one, comma, the number of states between energy epsilon and epsilon plus d epsilon is given by this one, g epsilon d epsilon will be equal to gs is going to be multiplied gs into 4 pi vm by hq into 2 pi m root over in 2m epsilon root over into d epsilon. Same thing it has been written, gs into 4 pi vm by hq whole root over of 2m epsilon d epsilon. Let this is your equation number 5. So okay, now if we are going to consider the electron is the particle, then the S is nothing but 1 by 2. The spin of the electron is 1 by 2, that is each state can be accommodated 2 electrons, one spin up and other with spin down, because here in case of electron S is 1 by 2, hence each state can accommodate 2 electrons, one spin up and other spin down, because Gs is 2. Here if we are going to substitute S as 1 by 2, then 2 got cancelled, 1 plus 1 equal to 2. So as degeneracy factor is 2, that means each state is going to again further splitted or degenerated by 2 whenever we are going to consider their electron. Suppose we are going to consider another fermion having the spin is 3 by 2. Suppose we consider another fermion. See, electron is a fermion having the spin is 1 by 2. But another fermion, suppose we consider whose spin is 3 by 2. Then degeneracy factor Gs will be 2 into 3 by 2 plus 1. That will be 2 got cancelled, 4. That means each quantum state, whatever we have been found, this is the number of quantum states, whatever we found by a single particle without any considering the spin. So whenever we are going to consider the spin or the fermions having the half integral spin, then the spin degeneracy factor is going to be multiplied with this one. So for the electron, it will be 2 into this one. For the other fermion, suppose having spin is 3 by 2, then degeneracy factor will be 4. That means each quantum state, whatever we have been found for a particle, again, it is going to be degenerated, or it is going to be splitted with 4, because here spin is 3 by 2 means its ms will be minus 3 by 2, minus 1 by 2, plus 1 by 2, plus 3 by 2. So this much type of spins orientations of electron can be possible in this single quantum state, or we can say the degeneracy of the single quantum state for the fermions having the spin 3 by 2 is going to be 4. Then one single state is going to be splitted again with 4 numbers. But here we consider the electron has the spin is 1 by 2. So that means its MS. Its MS is minus half and plus half. That means one orientation is up, another orientation is down. So each and every single quantum state is going to be, quantum state is going to be splitted or degenerated. Splitted means degenerated. See, this is the single state. It is again going to be split, degenerated. But the energy value, of this will be same for this one, but it will be degenerated. Same energy value, but different states. Degenerated by 2. So single state, quantum state is going to be degenerated by 2 for the electron. For other fermions, accordingly, it is going to be splitted. So in case of electron, S spin is 1 by 2. Hence, each state can be accommodate 2 electrons or 2 degeneracy we found. So then one spin up and other with spin down, because Gs equal to 2s plus 1. Here s is 1 by 2 means 2s plus 1 equal to 2. Then G epsilon E d epsilon will be equal to, here we have to just put instead of Gs as 2, then 2 into 4 equal to 8 pi mb by h cube whole root over of 2m epsilon d epsilon. Let this is your equation number 2. This is represents the number of quantum states whenever the electron is going to be concerned. When the electron is going to be considered, then the whole phase space has this much quantum states in between energy epsilon and epsilon plus d epsilon. Suppose we have a phase space is this one, and phase space, 3D phase space is this one, and one electron is present inside this vessel. So what will be the quantum states of this single electron in between energy E and E plus, sorry, epsilon and epsilon plus d epsilon? The value will be this one. So in between energy range E epsilon and epsilon plus d epsilon, the number of quantum states are this much for the electron. That means here we can say in the energy range d epsilon, how many number of quantum states are possible for the electron is this one. For unit energy range, it will be divided by d epsilon. We are going to get this one. That is your so-called density states. So unit energy range, how many numbers of quantum states of the electron we can found or fermion we can found, that is called as the density of states. As here we have been considered the electron, so density of states will be, now the density of states or DOS, that is number of eigenstates in unit energy range, will be just we have to divide d epsilon both the side. The g epsilon will be equal to 8 pi mb by h cube root over of 2m epsilon. This much number of eigenstates are possible for a single electron in a phase space in a unit energy range, that is called as your DOS, density of states. That is your equation number 7. So here we have to stop our discussion today. In the next class, we are going to discuss Fermi energy of free electrons and average. And then we have to discuss average free electron energy at absolute zero. These two topics we are going to discuss in our next class. We go through this topic and write down the note and ready for the next class. Okay. Also, these topics PDF, I am going to be give the link at the description. Also, you can download with the help of that link. Okay. So thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you.